Taylor, this is your first time being part of this. What does it mean to be to chip in? I think it is. Am I right about that?
Yeah, it's my first time.
And what's it like to join into this? Because you know what the cause is all about.
Exactly. It's awesome. I mean, obviously, like you just said, it's for such a good cause. And, personally, for me, it's the first opportunity I've had because I'm normally in Europe at this time. So for me to be here is special. You know, seeing some of the guys I played with, some of the guys that are before me, you know, all coming back, you know, for something so big, it's great.
How do you kind of put into words and describe the relationship that you've been able to build with Coach Chambers since he's arrived?
It's great. I mean, literally, from anything small to big, I know I can call Coach. I know he's going to pick up the phone and really speak to me. You know, and since now that I'm done playing, I've been really on the phone when I'm talking to him a lot, and he's been giving me great advice. So our relationship is really, really good, and I'm hopefully look forward to continuing to build it.
He said he wants to try and keep you around. What have talks like that been, and you anticipate that you're going to try to stick around here a little and help out the team?
Yeah, we've been talking. Like I said, we've been talking a lot, and that's definitely a possibility. Now that I'm done playing, you know, this is home, you know, away from home. So if I'm anywhere and it's got to do with basketball, this is probably where I would be for sure.
What are some of the best pieces of advice that he's kind of given you recently?
It's mostly been about, you know, coaching, and that's kind of what he said because, you know, I'm kind of looking to get into that, I think. So, you know, he's just been giving me, you know, pros and the cons. You know, he's shooting me straight, you know, and that's really all I can ask for.
So why is coaching appealing to you?
It's the only thing I've ever done, so I feel like I know, got some knowledge. You know, I played here especially. You know, I played at this level, so, you know, with the kids coming up, you know, I feel like I got a lot to share and give back to them.
What went into your decision to retire?
It was really just a lot of injuries. The past 2 years, I just kind of been banged up, you know, from shoulder surgery to tearing my calf muscle. Just a bunch of stuff, and it kind of really got to the point where it just ran its course. And for me and my family, I thought it was just the right decision for me to come back.
Watching these Patrick Chambers teams over the years, especially last year, how do you kind of compare and contrast the type of student-athletes that are on the team from when you were playing?
Oh, it's completely different. You know, the style of play, you know, Coach Chambers, we played a lot slower, scored a lot less. You know, so it's different, you know. But like I said, you know, for 2 years, we were really successful. That was his style. And Coach Chambers got, like, this high octane, score a lot of points. For the fans, it's really fun. For myself to watch, it's fun. I wouldn't mind playing run and gun in that offense. It would have been solid for me.
What do you think about Tony's shot at being drafted? I mean, how do you think he would fit in? You've played against guys at that level and know what it's all about.
I mean, the first time I met him, you know, it was just in the summertime, you know, his freshman year, and I immediately said he's got a chance to be a pro. And I still believe that, and I think, you know, with these workouts, with his size, the things he can do, playing in the post, you know, he's got an NBA body, so I hope someone really takes a chance on him.